We are at the Berlin War Memorial, and this is one of the few places in Berlin where you can actually still see the wall. My father came from the GDR and escaped to West Germany in 1954. He was only 18 years old then. The wall didn't exist at that time yet. He took a train to East Berlin and from there he went on to West Berlin. So it's not surprising that this part of German history especially moves me. In this video, I would like to take you to places in Berlin where this past is fading more and more or can no longer be seen at all. With the help of old photos, this past becomes more concrete again, more imaginable. And also, it becomes clear how much Berlin has changed. Let's go on this journey and start at the famous Oberbaum Bridge. If you look at the riverbank to the left of the bridge, you can see the Berlin Wall here too. Besides the memorial on the street Bernauer Straße, this piece, the East Side Gallery, is the most famous piece of wall remaining. But what you can't see anymore, directly at the place where we are standing right now, there was a border checkpoint. Here too, there was a wall. The East Side Gallery is actually the rear wall. The bridge was closed for a long time for any traffic, then from the 70s on at least open for pedestrians. Here is another picture from November 11th of 1989, shortly after the fall of the Berlin Wall. Today you walk or drive over the bridge and actually have no idea what you are moving over. At the next place this is quite different and also not. Checkpoint Charlie. Here the first construction of the Checkpoint Charlie of the Americans from 1961 has been reproduced. However, what is missing and actually is important, this picture shows. The East Berlin part of the border checkpoint was not recreated. Of course, it would take a lot of space to preserve something like that permanently. But all these buildings of the 8 Berlin border checkpoints have disappeared. Perhaps they could have preserved one as a memorial. We now walk just a few hundred meters further to the corner of the streets Charlottenstraße and Zimmerstraße. It's hard to imagine today, but the wall was right here. This was once West Berlin. Exactly along today's street there was the wall. The buildings that are here today didn't exist back then. Berlin was still much less built on. You can see it a little better in another picture. That seems somehow today almost enviable, such open spaces in Berlin. And not everywhere it was because of the wall. But that was at least here the reason, and it makes it, on the other hand, not at all enviable. There are many places in Berlin that are heavily built on today, but very little at that time because of the wall. Like the next place to which we go, Potsdamer Platz. Everything directly around us did not exist at that time. To be precise, we are not directly at Potsdamer Platz. This is Leipziger Platz. Potsdamer Platz is behind us and adjoins Leipziger Platz. The picture shows Leipziger Platz as seen from Potsdamer Platz. We are around here. That's really hard to imagine today. There is another place that shows quite similarly the change of Berlin along the former wall. It is not far away from here, the so-called Engelbecken. Here once was a canal that connected the River Spree with the Landwehrkanal. In the 1920s it was filled in, except for the basin in front of us, the Engelbecken, and turned into a park. After the Second World War a lot of rubble was filled in, and then after the wall was built in 1961 the area was completely filled in. Also the basin. It then looked like this. The wall ran through this area too. The Engelbecken was located directly on, or more precisely under, the Death Strip. Because most of the original park has been reconstructed by now, It is impossible to imagine that the death strip of the wall once ran through here unless you know it. We continue to the next station, a bridge, Treptower Brücke. Here too, you can no longer really imagine that the wall was here. But I do not want to repeat myself. The picture makes something else visible. Not only was the wall here. The picture also shows how much people got used to this situation. In West Berlin, the life extended right up to the wall. Several people sit just a few meters from the wall and fish. In a way, people came to terms with the situation. Along the wall it was silent, ideal for fishing. It was different on the other side of the wall. We are only a few steps away from the bridge, but now on the East Berlin side. The picture was taken shortly after the fall of the wall. Before that, it would not be possible to take a picture here. I suppose the people who lived in this building at that time also came to terms with the wall, but differently than the people in West Berlin. We continue our journey and move on to the street Invalidenstraße. A few meters behind us is Berlin's central station, but it was built only a few years ago. In the opposite direction, so in front of us, was the border checkpoint Invalidenstraße. Today there is nothing left to remind us of it, and it actually took me quite a while to find the exact position of the border checkpoint and the position of the photographer of the picture. It is also impressive how much greener this place was back then. Now we will go on to one of the great landmarks of Berlin, the Brandenburg Gate. The Brandenburg Gate is not only one of the great landmarks, it was also one, if not the symbol at all, for the division of Berlin. Besides the fact that the border ran here, I find something else very remarkable about photos from that time. The Brandenburg Gate was standing freely, a consequence of the destruction of Berlin in the Second World War. The GDR had no interest in reconstruction. This was only started after the German reunification. Today, buildings again adjoin the gate directly from both sides. Now we are going deep into the former East Berlin, to the boulevard Karl-Marx-Allee. The wall was definitely not around here, but I have found a picture that is directly related to the wall. In 1986, they actually celebrated the 25th anniversary of the wall, which the GDR leadership called the Anti-Fascist Protective Wall. A large military parade passed by here. On the tribune was, among other people, Erich Honecker, who of course also gave a speech. I find it remarkable that this can still be easily imagined today. The place has changed very little and the architecture of the houses is almost automatically linked to an image of the GDR and socialism. And with this a bit disturbing image, the time travel ends. I hope that I could make this part of German history a little more imaginable with this video. As always, thanks for watching.